what we need to do is design that with the family system. So you educate the family on what they've been doing in the past and show them that, okay, this one thing you were doing is supporting recovery. So you put a line in the sand and you say, okay, what you're doing here is supporting recovery. What you're doing over here is supporting the addiction. Like a good example would be, okay, you stole that watch. You know, we didn't arrest you because you're our kid. We're not going to arrest you for stealing that watch. But that watch was an expensive watch and it's a felony. So instead of pressing charges, you know, we just turned a blind eye to it and said, oh, well, another one that they screwed up and, you know, damn, we lost that watch. We lost just like we lost all the other jewelry. So that's what the families normally do. That's supporting the addiction. If they would say, I got a police report right here that I reported this watch stolen and I know that you took it, I'm going to turn you in and I'm going to have you arrested and you're going to face the consequences, the legal consequences, if you choose to leave treatment early or don't stay in recovery for 5 years. So the family has the power, but it's going against, which is heartbreaking to me, because it's going against all internal feelings of how to nurture a loved one. You know, the nurturing a loved one is turning the blind eye. You know, it's not turning them in. It's not having them arrested. I just did another one for the doctors. It was on the other day, and the mother's like, well, there's nothing I could do. I can't have her arrested. I'm not a cop. And I'm like, you're not a cop. I was like, she's sitting in your house, in your bathroom, smoking heroin, an illegal drug, and you can't call the cops and have her arrested? But they don't think of that. They don't think of all the things. I mean, I know every addict out there is doing something illegal.
Right.
Everyone, drugs are illegal. So they're doing something the way they're getting the drugs, the way they're getting the money for the drugs. So if you can find a legal consequence to motivate them to get into recovery and stay in recovery, you get along, you get a chance at, you know, I always look at it as, you know, like there's an angel and a devil on your shoulder, your disease is the devil, and the angel's, you know, telling you what you, you know, what you really want for your life, you know, because I don't know any addict that wants to be a drug addict and be addicted to heroin. Mm-hmm. So you're listening to that on your shoulder saying, oh, you know, today I'm not going to use. Today is going to be a good day. I'm not going to use. And then by noon, they're like, oh my God, I got to get to the dealer. And it's on automatic pilot. So they don't have anything to block them. But if they had that police report sitting there saying, oh, you go get high, mom's going to get you arrested for that police, for that watch that you stole, then all of a sudden that voice over here that's telling you, just go get it, just go get it, just go. The automatic pilot, it's a blocker. It stops them from moving forward and taking that action to get that drug. And that's what every addict needs, is that blocker. And especially for the first 5 years.
Go to killabycenter.com, Radical Recovery Summit, for access to the interviews. You can watch them free online for 48 hours after they air, or you could purchase an all-access pass. killabycenter.com